So welcome to the tutorial on Gomory Scut. We will solve another problem related to the Gomory Scut. So in the previous tutorial, we have seen the basic introduction about Gomory Scut. So we will solve another problem so such a way that we will understand everything in that Gomory Scut. So the problem is maximization problem, that is max z is equal to 2x1 plus 4x2 plus 3x3 subject to the constraint are 3x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3 less than or equal to 60, then 2x1 plus x2 plus 2x3 less than or equal to 40, then x1 plus 3x2 plus 2x3 less than or equal to 80. So now as you see in the previous tutorial, the same thing we can start. First you have to check whether the problem is maximization problem. So the problem is maximization, it is given in the problem. If the problem is minimization, you convert that into a maximization problem by multiplying that into -1. But normally in the case they won't ask a minimization problem. So we'll start with the working. So first we have to check whether the problem is maximization problem with all the constraint is less than or equal to type. So it is satisfied. Now we can process with the further step. Now we have to convert this less than or equal to with the equal to constraint. So we have to write the general form of linear programming, that z is equal to 2x1 plus 4x2 plus 3x3 subject to the constraints are 3x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3 plus s1 equal to 60, 2x1 plus x2 plus 2x3 plus s2 equal to 40, x1 plus 3x2 plus 2x3 plus s3 equal to 80. So now since we have added a slack variable, we have to put 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3. So the non-negativity conditions are x1, x2, x3 greater than or equal to 0, s1, s2, s3 are greater than or equal to 0. So now we will proceed with the simplex method. And another one condition for x1 and x2, x3 are they must be integer. Suppose if we get a fractional part, we have to eliminate that and we have to apply the Gomory cut so that we should get integer value. So now we will apply a simplex method. So the simplex initial simplex table is Cj. Cj is a coefficient of this. So 2, 4, 3, 0, 0, 0. And the basic variables are slack variables, that is s1, s2, s3. And the coefficient of s1, s2, s3 in objective function is 0. So you have to write 0, 0, 0. And the variables are x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3. And we have a solution and we have a ratio. Now we have to write the coefficient here, 3, 4, 2, 1, 0, 0, 60, and 2, 1, 2, 0, 1, 0, 40, then 1, 3, 2, 0, 0, 1, 80. Now we have to apply, we have to calculate Zj. So Zj is the multiplication of 0 with 3 plus 0 with 2 plus 0 with 1. So the answer will be 0. Since all the values are 0, you can directly write 0 in the first iteration. Now Cj minus Zj. Cj minus Zj is a value of 2 minus 0 is 2, 4 minus 0 is 4, 3 minus 0 is 3, then 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0. Now for the maximization problem, we can get the optimal solution by calculating whether if Cj minus Zj is less than or equal to 0, then we can get the optimal solution. But here Cj minus Zj is not less than or equal to 0, so we have to apply for the next iteration. For calculating the next iteration, we need to calculate the maximum value of Cj minus Zj here. So the maximum value of 2, 4, 3 is 4, so you can take this as the pivot column. So now for calculating the pivot row, you calculate 60 by 4, that is 60, the solution by the value of 4. So that is equal to 30 by 2, that is equal to 15, then 40 by 1 is 40, then 80 by 3 is some value will be there. So we have to, for calculating the ratio, we have to calculate the minimum value. So the minimum value of 15, 40, 80 by 3 is 15. So this will be the corresponding row. Now what we can represent is, so here by representing this, we can say that x2 is the entering variable and s1 is a leaving variable. Now we will go to the next iteration. So cj 2 4 3 0 0 0, and the basic variables are since this x2 is entering, you should replace s1 as x2 and the remaining things are same. Then the coefficient of x2 here is 4 and for s1 s2 is 0. So here I am writing the column values s1 s2 s3 solution ratio. Now we need to make this as 1. So what we can do is we can divide this row by 4. So the answer will be 3 by 4, 1, 2 by 4 is 1 by 2, then 1 by 4, 0, 0, 60 by 4 is 15. To calculate this value, we have to apply the formula like 2 minus 1 into 3 by 4. So 2 minus 1 into 3 by 4, that is 8 minus 3 by 4, the answer is 5 by 4. Then 1 minus 1 into 1, the answer is 0. Then 2 minus 1 into 1 by 2, the answer is 2 minus 1 into 1 by 2, the answer is 3 by 2. Then 0 minus 1 into 1 by 4, minus 1 by 4. Then 1 minus 1 into 0, the answer is 1. Then 0 minus 1 into 0, the answer is 0. 40 minus 1 into 15, the answer is 25. Okay, so now we will go for this value. 1 minus 3 into 3 by 4, 1 minus 3 into 3 by 4, the answer is 4 minus 9 by 4, the answer is minus 1 by 4. Then 3 minus 3 into 1, the answer is 0. 2 minus 3 into 1 by 2, 2 minus 3 into 1 by 2. So the answer is 4 minus 3 by 2, the answer is 1 by 2. Then we have 0 minus 3 into 0, 0 minus 3 into 1 by 4, 0 minus 3 into 1 by 4, that is minus 3 by 4. Then 0 minus 3 into 0, the answer is 0. 1 minus 3 into 0, the answer is 1. 80 minus 3 into 15, 80 minus 3 into 15, 80 minus 45, the answer is 35. Okay, 35. Now again we have to calculate zj. Zj is 3, 4, 2, 1, 0, 0 and 14 into 5, 15 into 4 is 60. Now calculate cj minus zj. So minus 1, then 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 0. Now again cj minus zj is not less than or equal to 0 since we have 1. So we have to again apply for the next iteration. Now by considering this will be the entering row, that is entering column, that is x3, and for calculating the row, that 15 by 1 by 2 is 30, 20 by 25 by 2 by 3 is 25 by 25 by 3 by 2 is 25 into 2 by 3, that is 50 by 3. Then 35 by 1 by 2 is 70. So the minimum of 30 comma 50 by 2 comma 70 is this s2. Now s2 leaves the variable, leaves the table, and x3 is entering. So now we can apply the next iteration. So cj 2 4 3 0 0 0, basic variables are x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3, solution ratio. So now the basic variables are x2, but we should not put s2. Instead of s2, we have to put x3. So the answer is 4. For the coefficient of x3 in the objective function is 3, so write 3, then S3, 0. So now we have to make this as 1. So you divide that by 3 by 2. So the value will be, you divide that by 3 by 2, the value will be 5 by 6, then 0, 1, minus 1 by 6, 2 by 3, 0, and this will be 50 by 7. Next step is, we need to calculate in the same manner we did in the last table. 3 by 4 minus 1 by 2 into 5 by 6, like that we have to calculate. So let me write the solution. So you can pause the video and you can check it manually. So the answer is, so here minus 1 by 5 by 6, then 4, 3, 5 by 6, 2 by 6, then 1, 80 by 3. So ZJ is 23 by 6, then 4, 3, 5 by 6, 2 by 3, then we have, so this is like, this is not minus, this is not 2 by 6, it is minus 1 by 3, just check, then 0, and this is 7666.67. Now we calculate CJ minus ZJ, this is minus 11 by 6, then 0, 0, minus 5 by 6, minus 2 by 3, 0. Now you can see, all CJ minus ZJ is negative, CJ minus ZJ is negative, so thus we get an optimal solution. So the optimal solution, the value of X2 is 20 by 3, the value of X3 is 50 by 7, and the value of S3 is 80 by 3. So now by considering only the values like X2 and X3, so we can rewrite the solution like this. The solution we got is X1 equal to 0 because there is no X1 here. There is no X1 here. We have got X2 equal to 20 by 3, X3 equal to 50 by 7. X1 equal to 0, X2 equal to 20 by 3, X3 is equal to 50 by 7. And the objective function is Z is equal to 7666.67. Now what you can do is, as you have seen in the previous tutorial, we need to convert this into a fractional part. The fractional part of X2 is, so 20 by 3 we can write 6 plus 2 by 3. The fraction part of X3 is 50 by 7 we can write by 60 plus 2, 16 plus 2 by 3. Now you can see the fraction part of X2 is 2 by 3 and the fraction part of X3 is 2 by 3. Now you can apply, you can either take this 2 as the value for the maximum value, but one more step is there. So if you take randomly any one value as the maximum value, this leads to a complication in the program or the problem. So to overcome this, there is another shortcut is available. So what you can do is you write calculate f dash of x2, that is equal to, you write the fraction part 2 by 3 divided by, you go to the x2 solution, x2 row. So here you can see you can see for s1, s2, s3, for s1 it is 1 by 3 plus, for S2 it is minus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 3. So you just convert that into a positive fraction. So the positive fraction is minus 1 plus minus 1 plus 2 by 3. So the positive fraction is 2 by 3, you write 2 by 3. Now similarly for X3 dash, you write the fraction part 2 by 3 divided by, you go to the X3 row. X3 row will have minus 1 by 6 plus 2 by 3, 0. So you take this two value, minus 1 by 6 can be written as, minus 1 by 6 can be written as minus 1 plus 5 by 6. So you take only the fraction part 5 by 6 by plus 2 by 3. Now you calculate the value. The value here is 2 by 3 and the value here is 4 by 9. Now you take the maximum value of f of x dash, x2 dash, comma f of x3 dash. So the maximum value of 2 by 3 comma 4 by 9 is 2 by 3. Now we can take x2 as the value for the Gomory cut. Now the reason we are calculating this equation is, since the fraction part is same, we can apply this technique. So this technique will reduce the complexity of the problem and thus yields the result in a faster manner. So now since the value of 2 by 3 is the maximum value, you can take x2 as the value. Now you apply Gomory cut. Apply Gomory cut for x2. Now you take the x2 equation. X2 equation is 1 by 3 x1 plus 1 x2 plus 1 by 3 s1 minus 1 by 3 s2 equal to 20 by 3. So now you can write the equation like this: 1 by 3 x1 plus x2 plus 1 by 3 s1 minus 1 by 3 s2 equal to 20 by 3. Again, you calculate the fraction, positive fraction part. So 0 plus 1 by 3 x1 plus 1 plus 0 x2 plus 0 plus 1 by 3 s1 plus, you can convert this minus 1 by 3 by 1 minus 1 plus 2 by 3. So you can write like this: minus 1 plus 2 by 3 s2. So 20 by 3 is nothing but 6 plus 2 by 3. You can write only the fraction part: 1 by 3 x1 plus 1 by 3 s1. Since 0 x2 is not available, no need to write. Then 2 by 3 s2 equal to 2 by 3. Since the constraint, it will be like greater than or equal to, you multiply that with minus 1, as we have seen in the previous tutorial. Minus 1 by 3 x1 minus 1 by 3 s1 minus 2 by 3 s2 less than or equal to minus 2 by 3. So we have to add a, we have to make that as a equal to. So we have to add a Gomory cut. So plus g1. So the equation for the Gomory cut is minus 1 by 3 x1, 1 by 3 s1 minus 2 by 3 s2 plus g1 equal to minus 2 by 3. So now we can apply this Gomory cut in our problem. So we will apply this Gomory cut in our problem. The resultant table will be CJ 2 4 3 0 0 0 0. Now the extra this thing 0 is for Gomory's cut. The basic variable are x2, x3, s3, g1. So you have to write the previous simplex table, the previous value x2, x3, s3, x2, x3, s3, and we have to add a Gomory cut 4, 3, 0, 0, and we have x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3, we have a g1, that is Gomory cut, and we have a solution, we have a ratio. So you write the same value as the previous iteration value. So 1 by 3, 0, 0, 2 by 3, 5 by 6, 0, 1, minus 1 by 6, 2 by 3, 0, 0, 50 by 7, then minus 5 by 3, 0, 0, minus 2 by 3, minus 1 by 3, 1, 0, 80 by 3. Then for Gomory cut, the equation is like this. So for x1, the value is minus 1 by 3, for x2, there is no value, for x3, there is no value, for s1, it is minus 1 by 3, for s2, it is minus 2 by 3, for S3 is 0, for G1 it is 1, the right RHS is minus 2 by 3. So now you calculate ZJ. ZJ is multiplying 4 into 1 by 3 plus 3 into 5 by 6, the answer is 23 by 6, 4, 3, 5 by 6, 2 by 3, 0, 0, and the solution is 7666.67. And calculate CJ minus ZJ, the answer will be minus 11 by 6, then 0, 0, 5 by 2, 1, 0, 0. Now you can see here, all CJ minus ZJ is less than or equal to 0. Now you may think that you can stop the solution, but you can see the solution is, we have x2 equal to 2 by 3, x3 equal to 50 by 7, and S3 equal to 80 by 3 and G1 equal to minus 2 by 3. The solution must not be negative, because the initial assumption is like all the values should be in positive, but here we got a negative value. So we should apply a method called dual simplex method. So in dual simplex method, what we will do in the ratio is we will calculate the least negative value. The least negative value is this, minus 2 by 3. So you can take this g1 as the value. Normally in all the problem, the g1 will be eliminated first. Then for calculating this thing, We have to calculate theta. So theta is minus 11 by 6 by 1 by 3. The answer is 11 by 2. 0 by 0 no need to consider, put a dash. 0 by 0 no need to consider. 5 by 2 by minus, 5 by 6. This is 5 by, minus 5 by 6. Minus 5 by 6 by minus 1 by 3, it is 5 by 2. Then we have 1. Then we have 0, then 0. So now what you can do is, you can take the minimum of 11 by 2, comma 5 by 2, comma 1. So this will be the minimum. So you take this as the pivot column and you can apply the simplex method. So the next iteration will be CJ 243000. The basic variables are X2, X3, since G1 will leave, S2 will enter, so S2. The coefficients are 43000. Then we have X1, X2, X3, S1, S2, S3, G1 solution. And the same thing we have to apply, we have to make this value as 1. You divide this by minus 2 by 3. So S2 value is minus 1 by 2. So that is 1 by 2, 0, 0, 1 by 2, 1, 0, minus 3 by 2. Then the solution is 1. Then similarly you have to calculate x2, 1 by 3 minus of minus 1 by 3 into 1 by 2. So I will directly write the solution. You can pause the video and you can check the values manually. So the answer is 7, solution 7. 1 by 2, 0, 1, minus 1 by 2, 0, 0, 1, 16. 9 by 6, 0, 0, minus 1 by 2. 0, 1, minus 1 by 2, 27. So calculate ZJ. ZJ is 7 by 2, 4, 3, 1 by 2, 0, 0, 1, 76. And CJ minus ZJ is minus 3 by 2. That is 2 minus 7 by 2 minus 3 by 2, 0, 0. Then 0 minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, 0, 0. 0 minus 1 is 1. So you can see CJ minus ZJ is less than or equal to 0. So we can stop the problem, and all the solution is also greater than or equal to 0 and it is integer. So you can directly write x2 equal to 7, x3 equal to 16, so x1 equal to 0. So thus we are getting the integer solution as the result. So we can stop the problem. Thank you.